Okay, today I'm here with you guys. If you haven't heard my music, check it out, please. This is actually my YouTube, so just click the link below or whatever. You know, today I'm actually here to show you how to build a studio. You know, no bullshit talk. First of all, I'm going to take you into mine. I'm not going to be discussing it today. I'll do that on a further or a later tutorial or whatever. But right now, today, I'm actually only going to be discussing just how to build a studio, you know, a basic home studio. You know, everything is going to cost money. So if you don't really plan on spending money, then I suggest you don't even do it. You know, just go and pay somebody else, you know, to record in their studio. But why do that when you can build your own studio? You know, you save up, you pay for this, and then you save so much money on studio time, you know. Sucks for people with studios trying to make money, but hey. First of all, I'm going to talk about the mic. Now, the Audio Technica, my brother has one. Any production that you hear from Ron Cash Production, man, that's off of that mic. Anything, any vocals and stuff recorded, that's off of that mic. It's a really great mic for the money. It's only $66. It's recommended highly. If you hear my stuff, it's pretty good quality. You know, so you know when I recommend something, it's going to be worth it. All right. Second, you need two mic cables, okay? A 25-foot, which is going to run from your mic to your mic amp. Then you need a 6-foot or a 3-foot. I recommend 6. You can never be too safe. But this will actually run from your mic amp to your Mbox Mini. These are only $14, $15. Don't cost too much. You know what I'm saying? I do believe most people will tell you, don't go cheap on your cable. But this is only a tutorial to show you how to build a studio. And I'm trying to make it affordable for everybody. Next, we have the Presonus Tube Preamp. Okay, this is a mic preamp. This is for your mic vocals to make everything sound crisp, to make you sound like you belong in the song with the beat. Have you ever heard of somebody on YouTube or somewhere where they're trying to record and it comes out and it sounds like butt, like ass? It's just like, what the hell is this? Well, that's because they either don't have a mic amp or their interface is horrible, okay? Which the Mbox Mini is an interface, but this is your mic amp. This plugs up to your Mini, all right? Next, oh, and it's only $130. That's not a lot. And they actually got a cheaper one, you know? They got one for like $40. It's an Art preamp. You know, just look it up, microphone Art preamp. It's like $40. That's what I started off with, but I moved and it messed up, so now I'm going to this. Anyways, by the way, man, if you got the money for it, do it right the first time. I just had to put that out there. Next, we're going to talk about the pool screen. Well, the pop filter. It's called different things. The pop filter, it's only $18. You need this because when you're rapping into your mic or you're singing into your mic or whatever, you know, when you say stuff like like P's and stuff, have you ever heard somebody do it like on a horrible recording and you can hear it sort of like, you know, basically pop. You know, you hear it in the mic and it sounds fuzzy and just distorted and all that stuff. Well, that's what this is for. This is so you put it on your mic stand in front of your mic, and as you're recording, basically it's got a material in front of it so that your breath don't make it past that, just your vocals. You get it? Well, this is definitely needed and recommended. It's only $18. It won't break your pockets. Next, we're going to talk about a mic stand. You need a mic stand. I mean, you don't have to have one. It depends on how ghetto you're trying to be, but mic stand is definitely a plus, okay? It's only $15. It's not going to hurt you, you know what I'm saying? Anybody with a McDonald's job can do this, you know? But next, we're going to talk about the Avid Mbox Mini with Pro Tools Express software, and this is actually the educational one. Now, I recommend this because the thing is, when you buy like Pro Tools and all this other stuff, you know, you actually have to go and pay for like different things in Pro Tools so you can have it. Like, for instance, you either don't get the bundle or you got to go and you got to pay for the MP3 mixdown. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just things that you got to pay for. Well, with this, the educational, it comes with all that. You know, you can mix it down whatever file type you want or anything, you know. So, like, I recommend the educational one, you know. And I know this is getting a little pricey. You know, but that's the thing, like, if you really want that quality, if you really want your stuff to sound professional, but cheap enough to be a home studio, here you have it, okay? Now, next, is the Art headphone amp. Okay, the 4-channel headphone amp. Now, this is cheap, man. It's $50. You know, they go, trust me, they go way higher than this, you know. But this is great, great for the money. Okay, I've had it since I built my studio, and it has never went out on me. I've never had to replace it like the mic amp. This is great, a must-have. Okay, now next is actually going to be a 3-foot quarter by quarter inch cable. Okay, and you need this because this runs from your headphone amp to your inbox, to the front of your inbox. Okay, and you need this because it's 4 headphone slots. So you run your headphones from the booth into your headphone amp, and then you have a second pair, because like most likely this is going to be your studio is only going to be just like, you know, a corner that somebody's rapping in or whatever. So if you have somebody in there, basically you run the headphones from the booth into the mic amp, or the headphone amp, I'm sorry, and then you run another pair of headphones from the headphone amp to just your desk, I guess, you know. And so you have 2 pair of headphones just so people can hear you, you know. Okay, well, next is actually going to be the Mac. Okay, listen, now I know that a lot of people are PC heads, and you might be scared of a Mac, you know, or just not don't know how to use it, or you don't want to invest the money. But listen, man, I personally started with a PC, man. I've had so many freaking studio problems, like it's unbelievable. Okay, listen, I haven't used the Mac Mini, but I recommend, if you have the money, it's $2,000. I know that, you know, but the MacBook Pro, I went to Full Sail, they actually hand it to you. You know, you pay them later, but it is so recommended, okay? It's badass, all right? Now, I'm pretty sure that this will do just the same job, okay? You know, Mac is the way to go. It makes everything so much easier. It's designed for things like this, okay? Any kind of art. Now, next, you're going to want to go, and it's only, I mean, it's like $600, pretty expensive, but, you know, it's worth the money, okay? And next is actually an Acer 23-inch widescreen. Now, this is just what I have. You know, it's only $150. You know, I recommend two because you're going to want something for editing, and you're going to want something for mixing. Now, like, it comes down to, like, It just helps. You know, you don't have to like click back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Okay, I'm recording, so I gotta be on the editing screen. Oh, well, I gotta put this plugin in. I gotta be on the mixing screen. You know, instead, you got two of them sitting right there in front of you. You just slide over, click, slide over, click. That simple, okay? I recommend two. You can do one. The bigger, the better, the easier it makes for you as a producer or a rapper or a singer to produce your own material, to edit it, to mix, to master. It just makes it a lot simpler. Next, we're going to talk about egg crate mattress. Now, you can either build a booth. I'm not going to go over that right now. I'll actually make a tutorial on that later. You know, but egg crate mattress, man, all you need to do is just go get a queen set, right? And then you take some tacks, or tacks might not go through, but you take either tacks, staple gun, nails, you know, whatever, and just literally, or you can just stand it up in the corner, you know. You just need something to keep sound from bouncing. It really doesn't matter how you do it, you know, but this is just the cheapest way, and it's only $43, you know. You know, you're really not losing. So, like, I recommend it. You know, I actually got a booth built with this in it, and then I just put some extra actual studio installation in it, just to, you know, for backup, just for safety precautions. Next is actually going to be the Kensington Universal Multi-Display Adapter, okay? Now, this is for to connect your monitors into the USB hub, okay? Now, you need to get a USB hub, but these are $56, so if you get two of them, you're going to need two. You know, if you get two monitors, you're going to need two, of course, but this is optional completely. And I recommend it again, two monitors, I really do, you know. I can't stress it enough. I didn't want to switch. My brother talked me into it, and after I did it, man, I can't tell you how much it saved me, man. Like, it just makes everything, the whole process, a lot easier. Next, you're going to want this, okay? You're going to want a terabyte. I know people say, they're like, man, you'll never use that much memory. You'll never use that much memory. Dude, I don't give a shit. You might as well get it now. Might as well. Why the fuck would you go out and spend 30 bucks on an external hard drive that's 250 and then all of a sudden that bitch is maxed out, and then like even a year later, you know, when you can get this and this bitch will last you 5 years, you know, like just go for the terabyte. I promise you. Seagate, I have a Seagate. Amazing. Not exactly this one, but look how much it is. You know, won't hurt nobody. Okay. Next, I have the USB hub. You're going to want this. This is amazing. I actually have this one. It's got two switches at the top. You can cut off the bottom six, or you can cut off the top six, or you can cut off both, or you can leave one on, or etc. 30 bucks, so freaking worth it. I'm telling you, you know, I mean, you have to have one because you need something to plug in all your USB cables. And trust me, you're going to have a lot. You know, mouse, keyboard, external hard drive, monitor, like it adds up. Okay, now next is just going to be this. This is your power supply, man, like you need it. You know, you don't have to have this one. You can go to Lowe's, and for 30 bucks, you can just get one that sits on the floor. You know, this is a rack. This is just, I felt like putting this on here because it's more professional. I do not have this. I have the one that you just click at the top, and then, you know, it's got like 8 plugins or whatever. And, you know, I would love to have one of these, but I just haven't found the time or money to buy it. So, but I recommend it. It's only $33, and it helps on everything. Okay, now, I haven't put the picture up yet, you know, but I will put a picture on here. So I don't know the exact name, but I recommend my AKGs. You know, the AKGs I have, I'm going to post a picture of it, you know, so you can see. And I recommend them because they actually have holes in the earmuffs or whatever you want to call it, where the speaker's at. And you can actually, instead of, you know how people go in the booth, you see them go in the booth and then they leave one side off and then one side on. Well, these actually have holes so you can hear yourself. You know, and it's just really convenient. I recommend it highly. You know, and they're great beginner headphones. You know, they're only 100 bucks. There are cheaper ones. And I'll actually post another picture of some cheaper ones that you can get. That would be great. Hey, I actually forgot to mention the speakers, you know, the studio monitors. And I really don't have these in my studio, but I know what they're like. I know their performance, and they're very good speakers. My godbrother has them. My brother has them. I actually ordered a package that came with them. And I just sold them off because I didn't need them. But, like, I know the quality. I vouch for them. But they're called Fostech Powered Studio Monitors. And it comes in a pair. And if you look them up and you find them in the right place, you can actually get them in different colors. Believe it or not, there's, like, 5 different colors. But, you know, other than that, just studio monitor stands, really. They're 81 bucks, but that's completely optional. You know, and at the end of the video, which you're about to see right now, I'm gonna actually put a price up there, and I'm going to add everything together for you guys. You know, this is not including, like, what I recommend, you know. When I say I recommend 2 monitors, I'm not going to include that in the price, you know. So this would just be, you know, with everything that you need. All right. Thanks for watching, guys.